Hey guys, now I feel I've harped on for many videos already on the importance of color correction and color grading. So rather than filling your ears with more word vomit, lovely mental image there by the way, you are welcome. In this video, I want to show you how to get perfect white balance for your videos in 2 minutes flat using one of these. Now before we get into it, you actually need to purchase one thing. But fret not, it's super cheap and I still consider it one of my best bang for buck investments in filmmaking ever. Go and get yourself a pair of these. A white, gray and black photography, white balance cards, whatever they may be called. Cost less than 10 bucks off Amazon. I'm going to drop a link for you guys down below. Now, when you do dig into it, there are actually quite a lot of technicalities around percentages of gray levels and materials and all sorts of other things. For the sake of brevity, I'm going to skip all of that. Also note that even without knowing any of that, I've gotten some really great results using this pair of cheap cards. But now, let's look at how we can actually use these to white balance our videos. Welcome to the outside world, and let's just for a moment assume that I've accidentally set my camera to the wrong white balance. Not that that ever happens. This will cause my video to end up with a strange color tint, usually a little bit yellow or a little bit blue. However, before I film any video, I will usually hold up my white, gray, and black cards and then film my actual scene. Once I'm done, let's cut back to the inside world. Now I have my video filmed, starting out with a shot of me holding up my white, gray, and black cards. The next step might be slightly different depending on what software tool you're using, but the principles are always the same and should apply no matter whether you're using Premiere Pro, HipFilm, Final Cut, or any other tool. Here I am in Adobe Premiere Pro with a clip of me holding up the cards. I can then apply any color correction effect to this clip that has a white balance selector, like the fast color corrector or the Lumetri colors effect, and then use that white balance picker to click on the white card in my shot. And voila, done, white balanced. If you are willing to put in just a little bit more effort for a much nicer result, give this a try. Apply a mask to cut out the inside area of the three cards in your image. Make sure you reduce the mask feather down to zero so you don't bleed over the edges. Next, bring up your scopes. I discussed the scopes in my advanced color correction tutorial, which I will link you down below, and don't worry, they're not as scary as they look. For example, have a look at your RGB parade. The RGB parade shows you the red, green, and blue color channels of your image separately, given that right now in our image we only have the cutout pieces for the white, gray, and black cards in our image. The RGB channels, the red, green, and blue image, should all be the same. Any difference in these channels means that there's a bit of a color tint in your image, and that is what we want to correct. The easiest way to correct that is to simply use a curves effect. Apply this effect to your video and then adjust the red, green, and blue curves to match up the red, green, and blue channels that you see in your RGB parade. Make sure that you match up the top end of the curves, which are the bright parts in your image, the middle ones, which are your midtones, as well as the bottom end of the curves, which is the dark areas in your image. This will fully balance out the color in your image across the bright, mid, and dark areas in your shot. Once you're done, you can also use the vector scope, again discussed in my advanced color correction tutorial, to verify that the colors in your image are all perfectly balanced. In your vector scope, you should only see a dot in the middle. There should be no spread around because any spread indicates a color tint. All of the pixels, the brightness, should be centered in the middle of the vector scope, indicating there is no color in the image and your video is perfectly balanced. Finally, simply remove the mask from your clip to reveal the final image and voila, perfectly white balanced. Now, I know that this video probably took a little bit more than 2 minutes, but I guarantee you, once you get a hang of this process, it'll take you less than half that time and you'll get perfect white balance for your video every time. And that's all there is to it. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button. And if you want a more personal way to chat with me, be sure to check out my Patreon page where you can get access to my private Discord server. Finally, if you want to see more, be sure to click these links up here on the right hand side. And with that, thank you very much for watching. And until next time, I will see you later.